Hello friends, in this video we will learn about the angles formed by the hands of the clock and the unit used to measure these angles. Today is Sunday, that means a holiday for school. But why are Golu and Bholu looking so sad? Let's find it out.
Uncle has not come yet, Bholu. It is already time for his arrival.
Yes, Uncle used to come every Sunday exactly at 9 o'clock to meet us.
Golu, did you observe one thing? If we look at the hands of the clock, they are making a right angle.
Yes, it is a right angle. Are there any other angles in the clock, Bholu?
Golu and Bholu carefully observes the hands of the clock. And then their uncle enters the house.
Hey! Why are you looking at the clock so carefully?
Uncle, do the hands of the clock form angles?
Yes, Golu. Now look, it is 5 minutes past nine now. If we look at the angle made by these two hands, they are making an angle greater than a right angle. In the same way, when it is 5 minutes to nine, then they would be making an angle less than a right angle.
But Uncle, just like we measure time in hours and minutes, can we measure angle in the same way?
Yes, Golu, you can. Angles are measured in degrees, just like knowing the minutes or hours by looking at the clock. We can tell how many degrees the two sides of an angle are making by looking at them. Okay, tell me about the angles you know.
Uncle, we know about three types of angles. Right angle, angles greater than right angle, and angles less than right angle.
Oh, wow! Do you know the measurement of a right angle, children? 90 degrees.
What is meant by 90 degrees, Uncle?
Look, children. When it was 9 o'clock, the hands of the clock were making a right angle. That means the rotation between them was 90 degrees.
Then Uncle, what will be the angles less than right angle?
Just think, when the right angle is 90 degrees, then what will be the angle less than that?
Uncle, they could be any number of degrees less than 90, such as 30 degrees, 50 degrees or 80 degrees.
Yes, Bholu, you are absolutely correct. Look here, children. The angle in the clock is now 90 degrees. Can you tell me what is the half of 90 degrees?
Half of 90 degrees is 45 degrees.
Yes, this is half of 90 degrees. That is 45 degrees angle. Okay, children, can you tell now what is the double of 90 degrees?
Uncle, double of 90 is 180 degrees.
Absolutely correct, Golu. Now look at this angle, children. This is double of 90 degrees. That is 180 degrees angle.
That means this angle is made by joining two 90 degrees?
Yes, Bholu. Children, now you have seen angles of 90 and 180 degrees. Can you tell how many degrees this angle makes by looking at it?
It looks like greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees.
You identified it correctly, Golu. This is an angle of 135 degrees. This is greater than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees.
Oh wow! How easy is it to identify angles in the clock?
Try to guess the measures of the angles formed in the following clocks. In this video, we have learned about the angles formed by the hands of the clock and the unit used to measure angles, that is degree. Can you tell me when the angle of 90 degree is formed in the clock? Think for a while. We will discuss this in detail in the next video. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples of angles formed in the clock. Thank you.